Now, let us take this problem. This problem is a brilliant problem, wonderful problem. Okay, basically he is asking at what time this Vx will be 0. At what time Vx will be 0. Okay, so this is if I think of VL, this is if I think of VC. Okay, such that what is Vx here? Vx equal to VL minus VC should be 0. Okay, now let us write equations for VL. Okay, so if I write equations for VL, for t greater than 0 is going to be, how much will be the final value for VL? Final value for VL means forget about this. Okay, because this is not second order system. Okay, this is separate, right? So in this case, in first order system, how much will be the final value across voltage, across inductance under DC steady state conditions? It will behave like a short circuit, so voltage will be 0. So final value will be 0. So initial into e to the power of minus t by tau, how much is initial value means before, for example, this is u of t. Okay, at t less than 0, this is 0. Okay, at t equal to 0 plus, this will become 1 ampere. Okay, at t less than 0, how much was the current flowing through inductance? 0. So at t equal to 0 plus, instantaneously current cannot be changed in inductance. So multiple times we discussed this, right? So this particular inductance at 0 plus conditions, 0 minus current is 0. So immediately at 0 plus conditions, current will be 0. If the current is 0, so total 1 ampere should go through this only. So that is going to be 200 volts. Okay, so that is initial into e to the power of minus t by tau. Okay, so how much is tau here? Tau, if I calculate, tau equal to L by R, so 0.1 divided by 200, because current source, it should be open circuited. Okay, so across the energy storage element, you have to look into the circuit after killing the independent sources. So this is going to be 1 by 2000. Okay, so this is minus 2000 t VL value, we got it. Okay, now let us calculate VC value. VC for t greater than 0 equal to, at t less than 0, how much is the voltage across this? How much is the voltage of this at t less than 0? 0, because that is u of t. So at t greater than 0, immediately after t equal to 0 plus, this will become 100 volts. Okay, now if I think of here, how much will be the final value under DC steady state conditions? Capacitance will behave like open circuit. So this is open, final value at t tending to plus infinite, this is open, this is open. So same 100 volts will come here. Okay, so for VC, final value equal to 100 volts. Final value equal to 100 volts. How much is initial value? Initial value. Initial value at t tending to minus infinite to 0 minus, it will behave like short circuit. So even if you have any stored energy, it might have dissipated to 100 ohms. So at t equal to 0 minus, how much is the voltage across this? It is going to be 0. Okay, so initial value, because from 0 minus to 0 plus, voltage across capacitance cannot be changed. Okay, so 0 minus, voltage is 0. So at 0 plus, here voltage will be activated, but voltage here will be 0 only. So voltage here is going to be 0 volts. Okay, initial value we got it, final value we got it. We have to find out the time constant. Time constant equal to RC. Okay, so across energy storage element, after killing the source, in the sense voltage source should be short circuited. So 10 microfarads into 100. 10 micro into 100 is going to be 1 by 1000 seconds. 1 millisecond. Okay, so final value, final plus initial minus final into e to the power of minus t by tau. So 100 into 1 minus e to the power of minus 1000 t for t greater than 0. Okay, now let us think of Vx should be 0. Basically, if I try to draw characteristics, okay, if I try to draw characteristics, see here, let me draw VL. Okay, so VL instantaneously it raised to 200. From 200, it will slowly come back. Okay, now if I think of voltage across capacitance, basically this value is 200 volts voltage across inductance at 0 plus conditions. Now VC, if you think of from 0, gradually it has to be raised to 100 volts. So somewhere here, this is 100 volts. So from 0, it will gradually raise. Okay, such that VL minus VC at this point, VL equal to VC. So this particular time we are supposed to find at this particular time VX equal to 0. Okay, such that VL minus VC should be taken. Now let us consider. Okay, so VL minus VC, so VL minus VC should be 0, meaning that 200 e to the power of minus 2000 t minus 100 plus, means VL minus VC, plus 100 e to the power of minus 1000 t equal to 0. This point I would like to calculate. So this is going to be 200 e to the power of minus 2000. Okay, let me cancel out this. So 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So 2 into e to the power of minus 2000 t minus or plus e to the power of minus 1000 t minus 1 equal to 0. Now let me consider e to the power of minus 1000 t as x. If this is x, this will become x square e to the power of 2000 t. So 2x square plus x minus 1 equal to 0. Okay, so x value is going to be minus b plus or minus b square minus 4ac under root by 2a. Okay, so forget about negative things, because negative time will not be there, because from t equal to 0 we are starting. So this is going to minus 1 plus or minus 8, 9. So under root of 9 divided by 4. So minus 1 plus 3 is going to be 2 by 4. So 2 by 4 is going to be 1 by 2, 0.5. X equal to 0.5. What is X now? What is X now? E to the power of minus 1000 t equal to 0.5. Okay, so let me calculate ln of 0.693. So this is minus 0.693 equal to minus 1000 into that time. Okay, so this is going to be at what time Vx will be 0, means see here 0.693 into the divided by 1000. Okay, 0.693 millisecond. At 0.693 millisecond, voltage across, or what, this particular voltage Vx. Okay, okay, this voltage instantaneously it raised and gradually reducing. This voltage is gradually increasing, so such that this voltage equal to this voltage at that particular instant Vx equal to 0. Okay, at what point it is happening? 0.693 milliseconds. Okay.